Welcome to the last class of the Animal Kingdom. In this last class, we are going to see the characteristics and examples of the class Mammalia. So it is our class, the mammalian class, where human beings also comes under Mammalia. So let's go to the example and the general characters of the last class of the Animal Kingdom. Now here, as far as the class Mammalia is concerned, so these mammalians, mainly these are the animals that bears the mammary glands, and they have the hairs which is present on the skin. Then here we have some classical examples for oviparous as well as viviparous animals, because majority of all the mammals, they are viviparous only, that give birth directly to the young ones. Here viviparous meaning the animals that gives birth to directly to young ones, this is called as a viviparous. Oviparous means the animals which releases or lays the eggs, they are called as oviparous. Motteiduvanta pranigalu athwa direct marigalige janma koduvanta pranigalu, adakke naavu oviparous and viviparous antu karidivi. That means in the mammals we have oviparous, motte iduvanta sastanigalu iruvantavu. Here we have ornithorhynchus, where it means platypus. Platypus and echidna, in one example echidna and karithivi, these are oviparous animals. And remember, ornithorhynchus meaning platypus, which is a egg laying mammal. This is most important because this is a classical example of your NCERT, which will be asked in the part of your CET as well as the NEET part. Okay. Then ornithorhynchus meaning platypus, viviparous, let's look at these different examples. Macropus, kangaroo, it's a scientific name. Macropus is nothing but it's a kangaroo which is restricted to Australian region. That's why the Australian people, they are called as kangaroos. Avrige now kangaroos antu karithivi. Kangaroos antu yaka karithara andre aa naadininda bandavaru athwa aa naadinal vasisuvantavaru. Then pteropus, it is commonly called as a flying fox. Camelus, camel, which already you know it. Macaca, macaca antu karithivi, monkeys. Then rattus is rat. Canis is dog. Felis is cat. Elephas is a elephant. Then equus, horse. Delphinus, common dolphin. Balanoptera, blue whale. Panthera tigris is tiger. Panthera leo is lion. Out of these, which is the biggest animal in the world? Jagatinaga atyanta dodda prani yavudu, which is the biggest mammal in the world? This is, which you know, it is a not delphinus, balanoptera, which is commonly called as a blue whale. Blue whale is the biggest and the largest mammal in the world. Then which is the biggest animal on the land, terrestrial medium olagade biggest animal yavudu? It is the elephant, elephas. Elephant is the biggest mammal on the terrestrial medium. Then which is the biggest animal in the aquatic medium, neer olagade iruvanta atyanta dodda sastani yavudu? The biggest mammal is balanoptera, blue whale only. Okay, so that's why totally entire ella animals compare madidaga biggest antu bandaga adu balanoptera, blue whale bartada. And remember the terms which I have written here. First modalige en kelondu scientific name illene naavu bardivilla, ee name kele kelthirtaru. Okay, in the part of your NEET objective part, it is of most important. En antu kelthara antandra, which amongst the following is a pteropus antu kelthara. Idar common name kottirtara, that will be flying fox. Okay, then they will give delphinus antandre eno, what is the common name for delphinus? It is common dolphin. Similarly balanoptera, already this has been asked once, it is blue whale. Balanoptera, delphin irbodu, then pteropus and macropus, these are the examples which will be asked most oftenly and most commonly. So that's why we are stressing on this part. Okay, so this is regarding the examples of the class Mammalia. Now along with this, let's look at the general characters of the class Mammalia. So out of the general characters, the first character that we come across in the Mammalia is where they are present. ಹಂಗಿದ್ರೆ ಅವು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಾವೆ, ಅವ್ರ ವಾಸಿಸುವಂಥ ಸ್ಥಳ ಯಾವುದು. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಬಿ ದ ಪೋಲಾರ್ ಐಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಸ್ deserts, mountains, caves. Look at their various habitat, so where they are present. Okay, so they might be present in the polar ice caps. Apart from the polar ice caps, they are present in the deserts also, they are present on the mountains, as well as they are also present in the dark caves. So they might be present in the dark caves, guhe olagade iruvantadu, like that of the bat, bauligalu ante en karithivi, usually they are present in the caves, alli kanisuvantadu. Okay, so that's why we call it as they are present in various habitats, and along with that some of them are also present in water, aquatic medium, neer olagadenu irthavu, like the dolphins. Dolphin is present in water only, right? River dolphin irbodu, oceanic dolphin ante irbodu, they are present in the water, aquatic medium, but they respire through the lungs. Remember, though they are present in the water, like that of the blue whale. Blue whale ant bandaga, it is present in water only because of its body weight. Body weight jaasi irthada, it is having a thick layer of blubber, fat and karithino. Due to this more body weight, it is present in the aquatic ecosystems. But how it respires? It respires through the lungs only. Adukoskara adu water surface ku barle bekaagtada, and once if it gets submerged in the water, neer olagade muligidaga, during its threat, it can be submerged in water for about 1 hour also. One task tanakano usreyadsadana irabodu. It is its adaptation, adjustment and karithivi to that aquatic mode of life. So they are also present in water. Few are present in water, but respires through the what? Lungs, right? Okay, so this is the first character of the class Mammalia. Then some of them So out of these animals have adapted to for flying. Okay, for flying irbodu athwa neer olagade irbodu ava adaptation anta karithivi. Bats, they fly. Bauligalu anta enu karithivi, avu mammals, they are not birds. Okay, though they have wing-like structure, a wing-like structure, it is made up of a skin, where we call it as a patagia and karithiva. Adu skin dinda madalpattirutada, but birds' wings are made up of feathers. Illi bats ogade feathers ant irangilla. Okay, so some of them have adapted to flying mode of their life, and some of them are present in the water. So that is, this is their adaptation. Then the most unique mammalian characteristic is presence of the most unique mammalian characteristic is a presence of mammary glands. Presence of mammary glands, we call it as a milk producing glands that helps in nourishing young ones. Okay, they give birth to the young ones, directly to the young ones. Viviparous animal olagade, the young ones has to feed on the mother's milk. And those mother's milk is produced in the mammary gland, milk secreting gland and karithiyo. Okay, so that's why the name mammalia, bearing mammary glands. Okay, so this is one of the most unique characteristic that we observe in case of this mammalia. Okay, then next is they have two pairs of limbs that helps in walking, running, swimming, flying, etc. So almost the two pair of limbs can be used for any of these purposes depending on the variety of animals. Then they have an external ear pinna. So external ear pinna, horagade nam kivi kanisutade idakke pinna antu karitare, ear pinna. So this ear pinna is present. Okay, so it is present in the cats also, it is present in the dogs also, it is present in the elephants also, it is present in the zebra, it is present in the goats, cow, buffalo, dogs, yavudo ond prani thodre mammals adakke external ear pinna antu irutav. Nammalli ears vestigial agiruvantavu because ear muscles are rudimentary, avu functionless madangilla, but in case of the animals the ears can move, kivigola movement aagta irthava. Okay, because still their muscles are active. Okay, so they have an external ear pinna is present. Then respiration is by lungs. Then heart is four chambered. Out of the four chambers, ivu naalku chambers yavu, two auricles and two ventricles. So that's why heart is a four chambered. Then they are homeotherms. Look at this, as we have discussed in the last session, aves are warm blooded, mammals are also warm blooded. Homeotherms, that means these are warm blooded. Warm blooded animals. Okay, then apart from this, how about the fertilization, right? So sexes are separate here. Fertilization is internal then they are viviparous, majority of them are viviparous except platypus and echidna, avu eradu prani bitu because they are oviparous, mote iduvanta ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳು. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವಿವಿ ಪ್ಯಾರಸ್, ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ದೇ ಗಿವ್ ಬರ್ತ್ ಟು ಯಂಗ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಎಸ್, ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಗಿವ್ ಬರ್ತ್ ಟು ಯಂಗ್ ಒನ್ಸ್, ದ ಯಂಗ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಸೆಂಬಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಟು ದ adults, adults kaltena resemblance torsuvantada. Okay, so that's why we give all these characters, and out of these the most important character is a presence of the mammary glands, where we call it as a milk secreting gland. So we can add one more point for this. digestive system is incomplete, not incomplete, sorry, it is complete in case of these animals, with two openings, mouth and anus. Then nervous system is very well developed, and majority of them have the social life. So all these other characters are there. Out of that, if we take the humans, humans are intelligent animals also. And along with that, let us take the part of the skin. Skin consists of hairs, okay, in case of the mammals. So these mammals, they possess hairs. So the skin bears hairs. Now along with the hairs, we have other characteristic feature of these also, that different types of teeth are present. Different types of teeth are present in the jaws. Okay, so different types of teeth. Teeth bere bere riti iruvantavu. Okay, so this is the character. Avu yavu bere bere teeth anta na nimge helthene. Okay, they are not there in the additional characters of this. Idrolagade characters illa, but what are these teeth? Now we have also different types of teeth. Namagu bere bere types teeth anta adava. Yavavu, how many sets of teeth are present in the lifespan of humans? Human lifespan olagade iruvanta teeth third set. The first one is milk teeth, halu halu antu karitivi. Second one is the permanent teeth, shashwata halu antu karitivi. Milk teeth are deciduous. Deciduous antadra udire hogtavu. Okay, almost at the age of 6, 7, 8 or 10, okay, 9-10 varsh olagage avu biltava, vapas en bartava, avu permanent teeth antu karitivi. The teeth which you have presently now, they are permanent teeth. ಇವು ಉದುರು ಬಿದ್ದು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ವಾಪಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾವ ಇಲ್ಲ? ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಡೆವಲಪಿಂಗ್ ದ ಟೀಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲೂಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ ಟೀಸ್. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ, ಸೊ ಕೀಪ್ ದೆಮ್ ಸೇಫ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ನಾವ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀಸ್. ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಟೈಪ್ ಟೀಸ್ ಯಾವುವು ಅಂತ ಅಂದಾಗ, ಇನ್ಸೀಸರ್ಸ್, ಕೆನೈನ್ಸ್, ಪ್ರೀ ಮೋಲಾರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇವನ್ನ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಷ್ಟ ವಾಪಸ್ ತಿರುಗಾ ಇದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಡೈಜೆಷನ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ರಿಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್? ಸೊ ದೋಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಸೀಸರ್ಸ್, ಕೆನೈನ್ಸ್, premolars and molars. ಇಷ್ಟು ನಮಗೆ ಟೀಸ್ ಇರುವಂಥವು. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ಸೀಸರ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ಇನ್ಸೀಸರ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಂದಗಡೆ ಏನು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾವಲ್ಲ ಟೀಸ್, ಅವು ಇನ್ಸೀಸರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಈ ಇನ್ಸೀಸರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೆಸರು ಬಿಸ್ಕೆಟ್ ಟೀತ್ ಅಂತಲೂ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಬಿಸ್ಕೆಟ್ ನೀವು ಮುಂದಿನ ಹಲ್ಲೆಯನ್ನು ಮುರಿತೀರಿ, ಏನು ದವಡೆ ಹಾಕ್ತಿರೋ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ದಮ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೀಸರ್ಸ್. ಕೆನೈನ್ಸ್, ಕೆನೈನ್ಸ್ ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಏಜ್ಡ್ ಕೋರಿ ಹಲ್ಲು. ಓಕೆ, ವೇರ್ ದ ಫ್ಲೆಶ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಟಾರ್ನ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕೆನೈನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾರ್ನಿವರಸ್ ಆನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲಾಯನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೈಗರ್ಸ್. ಅವು ಭಾಳ ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಏಜ್ಡ್ ಇರ್ತಾವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಕೆನೈನ್ಸ್. ಪ್ರೀ ಮೋಲಾರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ಸ್, ಇವಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ದವಡೆ ಹಲ್ಲು ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಗ್ರೈಂಡಿಂಗ್, ಫುಡ್ ಗ್ರೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀತ್. ಇವು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಟೈಪ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಮತ್ತು ಬೇರೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂತದಾವ. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಒಂದು ಟರ್ಮ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಹೆಟ್ರೋಡಾಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಹೆಟ್ರೋ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಹೆಟ್ರೋಡಾಂಟ್. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬರ್ತದೆ ಥೀಕೋಡಾಂಟ್, ಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಾಕೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಡೈಫೋಡಾಂಟ್, ಟೂ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀತ್, ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಟೀತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ ಟೀತ್, ಡೈಫೋಡಾಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ದೆನ್ ಬೂನೋಡಾಂಟ್, ಟೀಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಲೋಕಸ್ಪ. ನೀವು ದೌಡಿ ಹಲ್ಲು ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ತೆಗ್ಬಿದಂಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾವೆ. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಟಂಗ್, ತೆಗ್ಬಿದಂಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾವೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೂನೋಡಾಂಟ್ ಅಂತಲೂ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ, ದ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೈಜೆಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ T's. Idhukku now heterodont endu karithivu. Now with a common interest, I'll tell you how many teeth are present in the human oral cavity. Namma oral cavity valagade est teeth adavu. So we say 32. 32 teeth endu karithivi. Adarolagade incisors S2, canines S2, premolars S2, molars S2 anta bandaga incisors 2, canine 1, premolars 2, molars 3 endu karithivi. Based on this, we write the dental formula of humans also. The dental formula of humans is 2123 by 2123. You enta you enta. Now oral cavity na nalku bhagagi divide maartivi. Nalku bhagagi divide maartivi. Melgade kelagade. Na one side bardana ikade aste irtavu. Avaga count maadri est antanu nimge gotagutade. Okay, this is what is called as a idakanavu dental formula of humans anta karithivi. I have talked about the humans. In bere prani olagade dental formula bere adada. Rats anta navu tagondaga 1003 by 1003 anta karithivi. 0 antadra alle rt sirangilla annu antada. And in different animals we have this different formula. Okay, if you study regarding the mammals, you will identify different types of dental formulas also. Okay, so these characters we are not taking here, but either different types of teeth yav antanu antada, I just gave you a glance over it. So with this, let's end up the chapter here, the animal kingdom. And in the next upcoming sessions we are going to start with a new chapter. Okay, so till we start with the new chapter, what you have to do is, so prepare the notes based on the classes. Assignment questions will be also given for you. Just write those assignments, which will help you a lot. And be very alert, cautious, and aware about the online classes which are going now for you, because the second test which you are going to face, okay, in few days, in kelo din olagade second test nu barithiri. For that second test, this chapter will be there. Okay, so the name of the chapter will be also given in the group. Yava chapter antanu antadu helidirthivi. Format, exam format exactly same. First unit test enu baradre same format daga second unit test ant iradada. Be alert, because you are looking and studying at your academics. New academic olagade idiri, so that's why be alert. Adar bagge awareness irbeku. Okay, so what we are doing, na study madakatano illo antanu antadu asta depend aagutada. And how alert I am, amala na bariyanta test, whether I am writing it promptly or whether I am writing the Google answers, that also matters a lot. So we expect your textual answers, not your Google answers in the test. Yakandra final exam olagade key answers nimma text based e irthati, examples nimma text based e irthati. If you quote any other example apart from that text, that will not be considered. Adu consider agangilla elli board exam olagade. Adakage your NCERT is the Bible for your board exams. Okay, for the coaching part and all those, that is a different issue. Okay, so that will tell you. Okay, college start aadantara nimge helta irthivi. Again, don't ask the same question. College avaga start re anta kelabadre. College start aguvantada will inform you previously. Gotage aagtada, because the college has to start throughout the state. Okay, not only in our college, right? So with this, let's end up here, and thanks for watching.